The PlayStation 5 was finally revealed yesterday, and you'll either love it or hate it. And a huge name organization is dropping out of competing in competitive Rocket League and what that could mean for the eSport. Plus, the summer split for LCS is back this weekend with a little double lift saltiness for his former team. All that ahead next on The Breakdown. Hello, my beautiful people. We have added almost 400 new subscribers in the past few weeks to Checkpoint XP, and we want you to be one of those new subscribers to our channel. Do you know how easy it is to help support us? Just go and click that subscribe button right now and stay up to date on the latest in esports and video game news. Now that the begging's out of the way, let's get into the latest news. PS5 is revealed. Sony knows how to do presentations. Wow, that was one of those presentations that just kind of settled in stone where you sit on a certain debate. Was Xbox's pre-launch presentation that much of a disaster? No, not at all. But Sony brought the fire yesterday. Brand new Ratchet & Clank is an exclusive. A new Oddworld. That freaking cat robot game. The message to really take away from something like this is just how Sony went about doing it. No lengthy talks about nerd stuff that only developers are interested in. No attempting to convince me that the ray tracing of a teraflop is going to be quicker if the developers for games somehow make it work. No, they just stuck to giving me that thing that all gamers have been saying will truly sell a next-gen console. The games. In the future, this is the maxim that any company developing a games platform needs to remember. The games and the games alone is what sells 95% of all consumers on their product. It also didn't hurt that they finally revealed what the console itself is going to look like at the end of the presentation. And depending on who you talk to, it looks like the future of gaming itself or a Wi-Fi router comparable to the Xbox fridge that was shown earlier this year. My stance? It was a solid outing, and PlayStation looks currently positioned to really take the lead when the console wars kick off later this year. We'll be excited to see how Xbox responds in their next presentation coming up very shortly. Cloud9 quit Rocket League. The Cloud9 roster of the former Muffin Men, that is, Squishy Muffins, Gimmick, Torment, and Fireburner, are no longer competing in Rocket League for the team. Not only did Cloud9 announce the disbandment of the roster, but with it, they effectively stepped out of competing in Rocket League altogether. And it leaves a huge hole in the eSport. The Muffin Men, a collection of players who have long rivaled any other team and stood atop of what most of the other teams in the league were doing, had been together for 3 years now, and that is a bit of a longer stretch by eSports team standards. Squishy Muffins, one of the standout players on an already standout roster, will be joining NRG with Justin and Garrett, and will easily be the new standout team in the sport itself. The bigger issue here, though, outside of disbanding the team itself, is Cloud9 leaving the sport as a whole. While yes, Rocket League may not be a premier esport in the likes of League of Legends, Counter-Strike, or even Overwatch, it still is a solid contender for most large international competitions. COVID has done Rocket League as a whole pretty dirty, and it's going to be tough to see a huge bounce back for the esport overall. All of the competitions were moved online when COVID hit, and eventually saw 13 RLCS teams writing an open letter to Rocket League developer Psyonix about the lack of benefit having a Rocket League team can bring to an organization as a whole. Those are some choice words, and having a huge org like C9 pulling out can only spell the doom of more Rocket League teams in the future if something isn't fixed, and by then, it may already be too little too late. The return of the LCS this weekend, is it Liquid's time to win? Double Lift is back, talking his talk. And Team Liquid is the talk of the town when it comes to the LCS. The summer split returns this weekend, and it's impossible to talk about anything other than Liquid, TSM, and just what was the beheading of one of the greatest players of all time before he was unceremoniously shipped off to TSM where he had wanted to be all spring split. I mean, just listen to Double Lift talk about his former team.
The last time I was on TSM, our image was like completely untouchable. TL didn't treat me well the last split that I was on it. I just want to destroy that team like so badly. I want to humiliate them, I want to embarrass them. So any team that kicks me should feel scared, and I think Team Liquid should be scared.
But now, here we are. The summer split is happening and Team Liquid is again a playoff contender, if only because of how much parity there is in the NA region of League right now. Team Liquid seemed to run into problem after problem last split, from the Brock's of visa issues to Double Lift straight up just not wanting to be there. Honestly, he probably didn't even want to be there from the beginning of the split if we want to call a spade. And the fact that they were able to still qualify for playoffs up until the last week due to the myriad of tiebreakers. Team Liquid just did not have a spring split that was favorable. They are now hitting a mental reset by having a new player, Tactical, on the team, and another shot at qualifying for playoffs. and this has to be the time they would make it happen without Doublelift. If they fall apart and fail to make it to playoffs again, expect to see more players off the roster until the organization can find a lineup that are going to get it done when it matters the most. That's been another week of esports and video game news. While you're here, make sure you subscribe and check out some of our other amazing content, just like Checkpoint AFK. It's a video game and esport lifestyle show, so, you know, sometimes you do stuff other than play video games, right? I do. But you can too. It's all right. We talk about it all on Checkpoint AFK. We got it linked right here. Go check it out. It's cool. It's fun. My name's Ben Weirdbeard. And don't forget, we have brand new episodes of The Breakdown every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Come hang out with me. I love you. Mwah. You're beautiful.